Howdy folks, and welcome to another episode of World of Warships, with me, Couchface. So today's episode of World of Warships is with Sniper, and he is in the Russian fun machine, the Izmail. It is basically the ship you go to if you want to have fun in a tier 6 battleship. I will say. You could go for the Lyon as well. Mostly because that is just a meme machine. But the Izmail just have something. Maybe it's because it's still relative brand new. That is fun. Who knows? But Sniper here is showing us how fun it can be with an opening salvo of 18,000 damage with a citadel and, well, one of his friendly destroyers thinks he's a big dog and wants to try and push a giant battleship out of the way. And we all know that is not gonna happen. Kind of unlucky there with an over-penetration. But he slows down just in time that he's not gonna be completely covered by the island. So he only has to reverse a bit, now he just have to get someone to respot. Oh, and by the way, he's teamed up with me in this match, and there we have the AOPA. And as you can see on the minimap, I am doing a, well, some would call it a suicide run. But not as much of a suicide run as that was. So that is the first kill. A few citadels. 28,000 damage. And you can see I am doing just fine. I'm still alive. Amazingly. I'm firing torpedoes off left, right and center. Not hitting anything of course, but well, I'm not dead. That is the most important thing. I am not dead yet. And that battleship is gonna show Sniper. That battleship is gonna show Sniper a lot of broadside here, and he is gonna punish him for it. Of course he is focused on me. Torpedoes direct front. So there is that, and I do have some torpedo beat there. Oh yeah, I'm a pro in the crash bay. But sadly the battleship managed to get behind the island before Sniper is totally reloaded. Which might save his life. Mostly because at least he's clear of the island now, but the Sniper is sadly not clear of his island. So all those shells hit the... What is it? The island. Yeah. I know what I'm talking about. I'm professional. Well, not quite. Soon, I hope. Well, right now Sniper just have to get up to a decent top speed for a... I would say pre-World War battleship. Even though it isn't a battleship. We discussed that in the last Izmail video. It is technically a battle cruiser. But Wargaming doesn't like battlecruisers, so we're not gonna get battlecruisers. But so far it looks like Sniper is in a bit of a tri-spell here. Not much to shoot at, and those things he can shoot at is either behind an island or is, well, basically not spotted. So he is gonna speed up and get moving. And it is actually a relatively close match this one, because both teams control two capture circles. Alright, one of the enemy capture circles are pretty open to us right now. There, as far as we know, there isn't anything covering it. We do know there's a destroyer somewhere over here. And a Königsberg. torpedoes, but with a Crash Bay and Izmail, the Königsberger is not gonna be a problem. And I doubt the destroyer is gonna be a problem either, because when you see how much health he has, yeah, that is basically a mercy kill. And a broadside. Single over penetration is what it took to kill him. Enemy destroyer foundered. And that more or less leaves the capture circle completely open. There's still a Königsberg somewhere. But right now, at least he's not in a position to pose any real threat to us. And we are just about to enter the capture circle. And we do have someone over there, but he is a naked boat, so please look away. Taking a random shot there, who knows, we might be lucky. And there we have the Königsberg. And is he sailing broadside on to an Izmail with at least 12 guns? And he is, and he's not even varying his speed, he's just sailing straight. Well, oh, he is turning, he's turning. But is he turning fast enough? Nope. Enemy cruiser foundered. That is the problem with Königsbergs. As with other tier 5, 6 cruisers. They are made out of oil, citadels, and dynamite. And Sniper is just gonna get some cheeky capture points here. Because he's capping at least 1 or 2 seconds of the cap. Oh yeah, that's how you get XP, boys. So right now, the enemy team is basically doing the opposite to us. We captured their Delta. They are capturing our Alpha. But we are ahead of points now because, basically because Sniper has gotten those kills. But we haven't seen the Emil Batan in some while, and we know how Emil Batans have a tendency to sail broadside to things. It was actually the cruiser we saw before, the naked one. That was actually the Emil Batan. And I hate that boat. I tried it once in a training match. And there happened to be a carrier on the match, and doing all 20 minutes, I shot down one fighter. Alright, it was before the carrier apocalypse. But still. So, he keeps popping up. And that Iron Duke is sailing a bit of a straight line there. Maybe he's gonna... I think he's gonna hit Sniper. If he's not starting to turn soon, he's gonna hit Sniper. But not as hard as Sniper is gonna hit that Emil Batan. And bit of a spoiler. The blood Emil Batan is a damn lucky boat. Because that's a broadside at close quarters. And that is 6 over penetrations. He basically gets away with it. He's still dead. There's no way he's gonna survive that, because with 2 battleships at that range, and at least Izmail has that many guns, and then that I'm gonna call him an idiot, because he turns around, showing the other side of his ship.
cruisers suck.
Oh my god. Cruiser captain sometimes. All he did was to get his second torpedo launcher off. Alright, he does hit sniper, but come on. It wasn't even critical. A lot of battleships down there, but we do have a lonely battleship over here. Who is a much more inviting target. The enemy Colorado. With a fancy camo. Good initial salvo there from a sniper. Around 9,000. And the front of the ship pointing towards the enemy, making him a narrow target. And with that Russian armament, the Izmail is gonna be a tough nut to crack. While the Colorado is, well, alright, he's not showing a complete broadside. But it did begin to turn a bit too late, because that is a 13,000 salvo, and that was, well, it wasn't even a citadel. Of course it was not a citadel, Carl, we could have seen it. Alright, you know what I mean. But that is 100,000 damage in a tier 6 game with an Izmail. I think people are doing relatively well in this battleship. And there's another decent salvo. Next salvo, and he is gonna be dead. Question is, who's gonna get him? Is it one of either me or the Iron Duke back behind, or is it Sniper who is going up close and personal? Sniper's almost reloaded. Few more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I make fire when ready. And that is the Kraken unleashed. That's the end of the game. Let's see how he did. 2800 XP, alright. 111,000 damage. Top of the team. Not so surprising there. And some details for people who might like that. And he did end up making a nice profit in the end. But that's it, folks. See you next time.